sometimes things just don't seem to make any sense. Like what goes on in your head? It's as though everything's going round in circles. They say that's what life does. But at least when you're going round in circles, you're sure of ending up where you started. So in a way, you always know where you're going. I wish I did. Sometimes it's like you're playing games with life. Tempting fate. Knowing you shouldn't be doing something, but can't resist doing it anyway. And the only thing you're afraid of is the unknown. I suppose it's only natural, though, to be afraid of the unknown. But what would it be like if it weren't the unknown and we knew it? Though if you knew the unknown, you would probably know everything. And then you surely wouldn't be afraid. Or at least if you were afraid, you'd know what you were afraid of. Like the future. I used to dream about the future. Though I didn't know this would be it. Sometimes I didn't know it was a dream. It was like tapping into another world. I even saw this train crash in the snow before it happened. I thought it was a prediction. Until I saw pictures on the TV the next day. And they were exactly the same as in my dream. Trouble was, people didn't understand. We were at a friend's one night, and the woman decided she wanted to play a game. A dangerous game with the spirit world. I begged her not to, but she wouldn't listen. I moved away, as far away as possible. To the other side of the room, in fact. It didn't make any difference. After only a few minutes, she pointed to me. I already knew it would happen. I could feel it. She motioned that I'd been singled out. Someone wanted to communicate with me.
Why me? Why did
it have to be me?
Why did it
have to be me? The atmosphere in the room was overpowering. The air was so heavy. Hardly breathing. My heart was pounding. I could hear it pounding. Everyone could hear it pounding. If only they'd stop, I thought.
Please, make them stop.
I don't even know if I said it, but they looked over, and they did stop. But it was already too late. Afraid to go to bed, afraid I'd never wake up. I had to get out, had to get away. But how? And then she appeared, out of the shadows. I didn't know if she was real or not at first, but I went anyway. Followed her into the light, out of nightmares, and into dreams. And everything began again. funny, isn't it? Everything could change just because of a chance meeting. It was as though I already knew it before we met. And as soon as we were together, it was like we'd never been apart. At the end of the tunnel, or a great abyss? What's over the other side? A secret garden, or a wilderness? Light or dark, good or bad? Maybe we never do find out, because if there's nothing, we never do. But as long as we think there's something, we can't really lose. Because if there is something, we'll know, and if there isn't, we won't. And then we won't care, because we won't know. Strange what goes through your head when you've got time to think. Time to yourself. With nothing else to do. Have you ever stood out in the street in the pouring rain? With your eyes closed and your head turned towards the sky. You felt the rain fall on your face, cleansing so deep it almost touches your soul. I bet you haven't done that. Ever stood so still that you can hear your own heartbeat? And it's so loud it's almost deafening. And even though you're standing still, felt your body sway like you're in water. I fell into really deep water once. I couldn't believe how long it took me to reach the bottom. Nearly a whole lifetime. It was sort of like dreaming. Well, it was, till I realised I'd better wake up. Funny how everything slows down. Funny how you can look inside your own head and get lost in there. Maybe that's where we go. Sort of implode into our own heads.
Thank you. Thank you.